Hey, hey, ladies, gents, and in-betweens. Welcome to episode 33 of I'm Just Gonna Say It, with another edition of Evidence for Extraterrestrials. Today we're gonna zoom in on our close celestial ginger neighbor Mars, with the top 10 most amazing Mars mysteries, featuring new evidence concerning a possible Martian pyramid. No time to waste, I say. Here we go with number 33. So, today we are going to look at the top 10 mysteries of Mars. Now, with the daily discoveries almost of anomalies in all the pictures made by Rover, the reconnaissance orbiter, and all its brothers and sisters, this list could be endless. But to keep these episodes digestible, I don't want to make them too long. So, I made a selection of the most striking ones, in my opinion. Let's get started right away with number 10. Mars crustal dichotomy. Take a look at this topographic map of Mars. The first thing that you'll notice is that the northern hemisphere is mostly lower elevation, marked in blue, and the southern hemisphere is mostly a higher elevation, marked in red. Nobody knows why. This dichotomy is one of the biggest questions in Mars science, and there are several theories that try to explain what has become known as the Mars crustal dichotomy. One theory suggests that one or more giant impacts blasted away the crust in the north and left it lower than the south. And who knows, maybe it were explosions that did that. The other theory relies on internal processes such as motion in the mantle of Mars to arrive at this surface feature. Fact remains, we don't know. All we can say is that Mars's past was in all likelihood pretty violent. On to number 9. But before we do, I'm going to ask you to, if you like this video, click like and subscribe if you haven't done so already. Furthermore, I will be grateful and forever in your debt if you share this video for me as well. If you wish to support us further, links are included in the description to my Patreon page and to the channel merchandise store. Now quickly on to number 9. Phobos Monolith. As you may remember from episode 30, the news of an anomaly on the surface of Phobos, one of Mars's mini-moons, was first brought to us by our loose-lipped friend Buzz Aldrin during a TV interview. Let's have a look.
We should go boldly where man has not gone before. Fly by the comets, visit asteroids, visit the moon of Mars. There's a monolith there, a very unusual structure on this little potato-shaped object that goes around Mars once in 7 hours. When people find out about that, they're going to say, who put that there? Who put that there? Well, the universe put it there. If you choose, God put it there.
As Buzz just said, Phobos is a small potato-shaped rock that orbits Mars, seen here in full rotation. On the surface, a strange monolith is located, estimated to be over 300 feet high and over 200 feet wide. NASA, in typical fashion, suggests this is a piece of rock that broke off, but from where is unclear to me. Aside from being strange, it's also an eerie reference to the movie 2001 A Space Odyssey, fueling all kinds of theories online. Theories I won't go into now, or ever probably. Time for number 8. Phobos 1 and 2. Now the Phobos mystery doesn't end at the monolith. In 1988 the Russians launched two probes in space called Phobos 1 and Phobos 2, with the intention to put these in Mars orbit. However, Phobos 1 failed to ever reach Mars due to a combination of a communications error and some faulty programming, causing it to shut down its boosters. Phobos 2 did reach Mars orbit, but shortly after, when it was trying to align alongside Phobos to shoot some images, it too suddenly lost contact with Russian mission control. Phobos 2 did manage to make and send back almost 40 images of both Mars and Phobos before it mysteriously lost contact. And they were strange to say the least. Some show what appears to be an artificial grid pattern on the surface of Mars. They showed up both on the normal as well as the infrared images and fueled a lot of speculation. But this wasn't all. The last two images it sent back showed strange elliptical cylindrical objects, one estimated to be around 12 miles in length, casting a shadow on the Martian surface, and the other over 20 miles in length, hovering next to Phobos. It didn't take long, of course, for people to speculate about the involvement of these objects in the strange demise of the Phobos probes. And I must admit, the option is the first one to come to mind, especially when you've just discovered a strange monolith as well. I bet the monolith reads, "All trespassers will be shot." On to number 7. Gigantic entrances. Aside from the Russians, NASA, of course, has also provided us with a wealth of images, both from the Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter, the rover, and other projects. A lot of things seemingly artificial in nature are seen in these images, according to many people. But most striking are what appear to be huge entrances that lead beneath the surface and into mountains. I have to admit they are pretty incredible. These are but a couple of prime examples of a plethora of strangely placed and/or shaped holes all over the Martian surface. And now on to Cydonia, where the most intriguing anomalies are found. Starting off, of course, with the face on number 6. Face of Cydonia. In 1977, pictures made by the Viking 1 and 2 probes were released showing what appeared to be a face on the surface of Mars. Years later, after new missions had surveyed the area once more clear pictures were released, which made the previous assessment appear to be a case of pareidolia. The human tendency to recognize faces in basically everything. Still though, we can't be sure. If the face was made millions of years ago, erosion will have done a number on it. I mean, just take the average human after only 70 years. And we can't be sure that never a straight answer NASA even showed us the unedited pictures in the first place. This example here shows us their tendency to blur. But it doesn't stop at the face. More structures riddle the plains of Cydonia, starting with number 5. Pyramid of Cydonia. Obvious pyramid-shaped mounds inhabit the Cydonia plains, leading to speculations what's underneath. I think it is unlikely that nature would produce such symmetrical and right-angled shapes, but then again, it is on Mars, not Earth, so we can be sure. Now, many experts on this subject speculate that this is a five-sided pyramid that actually hides underneath this mound. Now, of course, I see why they would come to that conclusion, but I found some evidence suggesting it might, after all, be a regular four-sided one. Here's why. A few things stood out to me, so let's have a look at Google Mars. Here we have our red-nosed neighbor. As we fly to Cydonia, you can see the face here, and as we continue down, we are faced with this. So let's get the ruler to illustrate some features. First of all, check out the size. The base is more than 2.2 kilometers wide, and from the bottom level to the apex of the pyramid is about 1.8 kilometers, assuming a four-sided pyramid hides underneath. That means the distance from any of its four corners to the center of the pyramid base equals half of 2.2, which equals 1.1 kilometers. If we apply some Pythagoras, that makes for a height of 1.8 squared minus 1.1 squared, which gives us a height of 1.42 kilometers. Aside from showing us that it is insanely large, we can use this number to calculate the slope. And guess what? That gives us an angle of roughly 52 degrees, very close to the Gizeh Pyramid's 51.5 degrees. And let's not forget, we just used my crude measurements. If we use 1.11 instead of 1.10, for instance, the slope would be almost 51.5 degrees as well. And the similarities don't end there. What also caught my eye was this. It's perfectly aligned to north, south and east, west, just like the ones on the Gizeh Plateau. Pretty amazing, right? And this isn't the only possible pyramid on Mars. Many pyramid-shaped objects litter Mars's surface. And now to number 4. Downtown Cydonia. Close to the face and the pyramid is a lot of other rubble which people call the city. also because of the strange patterns on the ground, just as the Russians had observed earlier. As an Earthling, I must say that it definitely does not appear to be a natural formation, but who knows what is possible on Mars. Combined with all the other evidence though, the case becomes stronger. In addition, what appear to be glass tubes can be found all along Mars's surface, here and there breaking the surface, I mean, revealing glass-like ripped tunnels. Again, these features are hard to imagine as being created by nature, but without more knowledge of Mars's atmosphere, its core and other variables, we can't be sure they aren't natural. But once again, all of these points combined paint a definite picture. And we are not done yet. Here is number 3. Cydonia star map. So it gets even weirder. You remember how the pyramids on Earth appear to be perfectly lined up with Orion's belt, with the Nile playing the part of the Milky Way? The same appears to be the case with the Cydonia pyramid, the face and the city. As you can see here, they perfectly line up with Orion as well. And with the Pleiades too. When you combine these facts, the chance of all these similarities occurring by chance becomes very slim. On to the next point on our list, number 2. Gale crater anomaly. In the Gale crater, on Mount Sharp to be exact, there appears to be a structure as well. This is one of my personal favorites, as the image leaves little to the imagination. Let's take a look at this image from Mars Rover and play around with the settings of the image a bit. As you're going to see when we enhance the contrast and tweak the light a little, something appears from out of the haze. It looks to be some sort of train station type construction, for lack of a better term, leading right into the mountain. Here you can see bridges, and along this long line here, what appear to be actual pillars can be seen supporting it. That should have you seeing stars by now. So on to a montage of Mars anomalies to close this list and have you relax a little. There are so many different anomalies found on Mars that we can't possibly cover them all in a single video. We can, however, show you a shitload of them in a montage, so that's what we're gonna do. So just relax and be amazed for this last item on our list, number 1. Mars anomalies.
Thank you.
And on that note, we are saying goodbye to this episode and to each other. Once again, please like, share and subscribe. If you have any questions, suggestions or remarks, don't hesitate to leave them in the comments below. Also, please check out our brand new Facebook page at facebook.com/IJGSI. And click like there, of course. The next episode is another edition of Utopolis 1, and kind of overlaps with Spirit Seekers as well. The topic will be the illusion of free will. If you enjoy having your brain twisted to its limits, you don't want to miss that one. The episode after that will be the first in another new series on parapsychology called Proof for the Paranormal. Or P4P. More on that in the coming weeks. So until the next episode, love y'all, sayonara.